Welcome to ACC 14. My name is Dr. Mark Creager, and I'm with Dr. Tim Gardner. And we've just been at the late-breaking clinical trials where the CoreValve trial was presented, which compared transcatheter aortic valve replacement to surgical aortic valve replacement in high-risk patients. Tim, perhaps we could first tell the audience the salient features of this trial?
Well, first of all, this was a trial of the Medtronic CoreValve, which, as you pointed out in the title, is a slightly different transcatheter valve for aortic valve replacement than the Edwards Sapien valve, which we have heard about already. So this was the first time we've seen this comparison with the Medtronic valve, CoreValve, and a very important presentation, similar to the PARTNER trial presentation that we heard a couple of years ago.
Right. So what is some of the differences in the type of valve between the CoreValve and the PARTNERs?
The CoreValve is a self-expanding valve. It's a very neat technique, and it's inserted with a catheter, and when it's released from the catheter sheath, it expands. It obviously has to be landed just right in the aortic valve area, but it has a different mechanism, self-expansion, with, I think, a nitinol frame, as opposed to the balloon-expanded technique that's used with the Edwards Sapien valve.
Right, and the patient population in this trial was high-risk surgical patients.
Yes, and this is comparable to the PARTNER A trial, the Cohort A trial with the Sapien valve. So in both of these trials, they enrolled high-risk surgical patients with a surgical arm and compared that to the transcatheter valve.
And what were the main findings?
Well, the transcatheter valve group did better, both in terms of mortality, and importantly, they did fairly well comparably in terms of stroke complications.
Right. So the primary endpoint was mortality at 1 year?
Yes.
And then stroke plus mortality was an important secondary endpoint.
Yes, they looked at all-cause mortality and stroke as well. So this trial suggests that the transcatheter valve technique using the CoreValve is superior in these high-risk patients. You know, there are lots of aspects of it. There's a complicated statistical analysis, but the main findings, the superiority finding, looks pretty solid based on the data that they presented this morning.
Did you notice whether any particular complications seemed to occur more or less in one group versus the other?
Importantly, with the CoreValve, and we knew this from previous presentations about the CoreValve experience from Europe and elsewhere, these patients have a fairly significant incidence of the need for pacing after surgery. And that has something to do with the pressure applied to the subvalvular area by the self-expanding valve mechanism.
Right. And then in the surgical group, there was actually less perivalvular regurgitation.
Yes. And that may also be explained by the nature of the self-expansion device.
What was particularly impressive to me was that overall the anticipated mortality rate in both groups, both those undergoing surgery and those getting the transcatheter technique, were lower than expected, really underscoring the fact that the operators were really a very high quality group. And that really indicates how well this trial, one of the indicators of how well this trial was performed.
Yeah, I think it was a very credible trial. The groups engaged, both the surgeons and the interventional cardiologists, are very experienced. And as you point out, the expected mortality, predicted mortality, was higher than the observed mortality in both groups. But that also may reflect a bit of improvement in our techniques, both surgical and interventional, and maybe our risk prediction models are a little outdated. But at any rate, the quality of the work, both surgical and interventional, seems to have been very good.
So you're a cardiac surgeon.
Yes.
What implications do you think this will have moving forward to comparable patients, those who are deemed high risk for surgical aortic valve replacement with severe aortic stenosis?
Well, you know, there are a lot of things we don't know yet. We don't know the durability of these transcatheter valves. But I would say that for a elderly patient who is quite symptomatic and has risk factors for surgery that are clear in terms of calcification in the aortic root or renal insufficiency or whatever, you know, I think you would tilt in favor of using a transcatheter valve if possible. So I think this is another bit of evidence, significant evidence, that transcatheter valve replacement in elderly high-risk patients is appropriate and should be considered. You know, individual patient characteristics may determine some of these considerations, but this is a pretty strong study showing the effectiveness and the safety of transcatheter valve replacement.
Yes, I agree. I think this is a very high-quality study done by very credible investigators with very impressive results, and I think this will probably contribute to moving the pendulum more towards transcatheter aortic valve replacement for patients comparable to those enrolled in this trial.
I agree.
Well, thank you again, and this is ACC 14, Dr. Tim Gardner, Dr. Mark Creager.